Breakfast Nation fans and KLP Worldwide fans, welcome back to the channel of KLP Entertainment. It's your boy, Kennedy Lucas, back for another The Lucas Review. Who's ready? So, welcome back, guys, again. Of course, we're going to be talking about the hit movie Vice, brought to you by, of course, Swanky Radio. If you haven't listened to Swanky Radio's app or Swanky Radio's Spotify account, go check it out right now. I'll have it in the link description below. Please go check it out because it is booming right now. I really want to thank everyone who listened to Swanky Radio and looked at our app. So, let's get on with the Lucas Review. Of course, we're going to be talking about the hit movie Vice. Now, this movie I saw last night, to be honest. I saw it, came out Christmas Day, and we saw it the 26th, so that was last night. By the time you're seeing it, it's going to be a couple days old, but I saw it last night. Of course, Vice was a very, very good movie. Of course, it's the story of Dick Cheney and his wife, and his role as vice presidency with George Bush. So, it's very historical. This movie, I really like movies like this because it's very, you're portraying history. This stuff actually happened, you know. Dick Cheney was going through a lot of stress when 9/11 hit because he was vice president at the time and he was overruling the president at the time. And of course, he's trying to make his own decisions to make sure that America is safe from 9/11. Now, we all remember 9/11. That was a very, very sad day and a sad year for all of us. I remember where I was in 9/11. This was very impactful to school. I was in grade school back in 2001. I was very young, but I understood what was going on. My parents were sad. My siblings were sad. I read it all over the news. Like, okay, what's going on? Things are blowing up. What's going on? World Trade Center. It's going down. Like, what's going on? You know. So, to really understand it, you guys have to, you know, you had to see it. You have to notice, and it has a little bit to do with politics, of course. I'm not going to go to politics on today's show. That's not what I do. But it was a very emotional day. I remember, I think we had chili that day for dinner, and we were just so sad eating our chili because it was just very impactful for all of us out there. So this is what the movie is about. Vice, of course. It was going through 9/11, of course. Dick Cheney did a lot of stuff. You know, he was like secretaries and chief of staff, and now he's vice president. And he was CEO of an oil company. So this man really did do a lot. He did a lot of work out there in his lifetime. Of course, he had several heart surgeries. Of course, he had heart attacks and heart disease for his health. So it's just very good that, you know, they portrayed it. Of course, played by Christian Bale. Of course, we all know Christian Bale. He was the Dark Knight, which he's never going to come back to the Dark Knight. I wish he would, because he was one of the best Batmans. But besides the point, he played Dick Cheney in the hit movie Vice. Of course, you had Amy Adams to play Lynn Cheney, Dick Cheney's wife. Of course, you had the amazing Steve Carell to play Donald. I can't pronounce the last name, but he was one of the congressmen back in the day. Of course, Tyler Perry. Tyler Perry was in this movie. He didn't really... My brother said, yeah, Tyler Perry's in this movie, and I didn't believe him at first, but when we saw the movie, it's like, oh yeah, that's Tyler Perry. So he played Colin Powell. Colin Powell was one of the congressmen back in the day. He really portrayed it really well. It was just funny to see that, you know, Tyler Perry played a serious role like that, because, you know, I'm not saying that Tyler Perry's not a good, he's a phenomenal actor and a great movie maker. He's one of my role models. That's when I started to do films, because of him. But it's just very funny to see him play a character like that. So, Tyler Perry was in the movie. Of course, you've got Steve Rockwell to play George Bush. George Bush's son. So it's not Jeb, but it's Jeb's father, I think. I hope so. So you had all these great actors to really play that out. And let me tell you why this movie is just so good, because everyone had a good costume design. Of course, Christian Bale looked just like Dick Cheney. You got Sam Rockwell to play George Bush, did a phenomenal job on that. Tyler Perry again, Colin Powell, his makeup was really good to make him look very old and very majestic, old looking. Steve Carell's makeup designer did really well. They did two phases. They did two phases for him, Steve Carell. So he played a younger Donald, I can't pronounce his last name, and then a very older version when they served under the presidency and they got a little bit older, as well as Dick Cheney for Christian Bale. They did a young Dick Cheney, a very middle-aged Dick Cheney, a very old man Dick Cheney. So it was just really cool to see in this movie that their costume design really went well. Of course, again, you're going by the history of Dick Cheney. Of course, he's trying to help run the country alongside with the president. Of course, he wants to achieve. And of course, mid by the movie, I was watching the movie, of course, in theaters, and there is a scene where, you know, he achieved his minor stuff, and the credits roll early, and it's just like, whoa, is that it? Is that the end of the movie? Turns out, it was just kind of a spoof kind of thing. You know, this movie was very comedic at some points. At the very beginning of the movie, of course, the very beginning when you start the movie, it says the following was based off a true story, is what it said. And then we try to portray some of the images of the historical Dick Cheney. But in the end, and then at the very, very bottom, it says we did our fucking best, excuse my language, but we said it at the bottom, so that was very funny to see and say, okay, they tried. And then they wrote the credits, and it was just like, oh, is this it? But turns out it was just another transition scene to where George Bush's campaign manager calls Dick Cheney to say, hey, Dick Cheney, you want to be a vice president? We're running for president. I need you to be the vice president, of course. So it's just very interesting to see that the story goes on. Of course, you know, expanding the story of Mary Cheney and her coming out of the closet, and the rest of the family didn't really agree with it because, as we all know, back in the day, people say it was shameful to be gay. I'm very glad that, you know, being gay now is very open. Simply because, you know, it's 2018, about to become 19. This is not 2001 or 2002. This is the next generation, because I have a lot of gay friends. So it's just really good to see that that's more open now. Back then, when Mary Cheney came out, it was a very disgraceful thing, you know. But Dick Cheney, the father, of course, he accepted Mary for who she is. And then her sister ran for representative for Wyoming, and then she said that she didn't support it. So it's just very sad to see that her own sister didn't like it, didn't really support it because she wanted those votes. So again, that's very, very political kind of thing with that. I'm not gonna talk about so much politics on the Lucas Review, because that's not what we do on the channel, but it's just very interesting about this movie. This movie was one of the greatest movies. You had all these Academy Award winners into this movie. I honestly think they're going to win some sort of Oscar that's coming up in, I believe it's late January or February, one of those 2 months. I should know that as a director. So you got the Oscars coming up very, very soon, and I would love it to see that Vice has been nominated for something in there in the Oscars, because they really did really well in this movie. I really did like what Adam McBrady, I think that's his name, of the director, he did. If you're watching it somehow, the Lucas Review, you really did a good job, and I envy that. I really envy movies like that to tell a story. You also saw this, nobody played Nixon, President Nixon, but they played an overview of Nixon resigning from presidency. It was very interesting to see that, because once I saw that scene, I thought about Frost Nixon, that another movie that Frank Langella played President Nixon, and he had to react what President Nixon said on his resignation speech. So it's very interesting when he said, oh, I'm not a quitter. And then I picture Frank Langella saying, I'm not a quitter, in his voice in Frost Nixon. So it's just movies like that I geek out about, simply because it was just really, really cool to see them telling the story, and they having a little bit of comedic kind of vibe to it, and you had a narrator to narrate through the movie, so that was really cool to see. Again, if you haven't seen Vice yet, I really do encourage you to go see this one, not only because it's, you know, you got your favorite actors like Christian Bale or Sam Rockwell, and Amy McAdams or Tyler Perry. You have history. I love my history movies. Not a lot of young people, and I'm not going to say that too much because I'm young myself. I'm super young. But a lot of people that's born in like 2001, they don't understand what really happened. I fully don't understand everything because I was only born in 1996. But I knew a little bit about Dick Cheney. I knew a little bit about 9/11, what's really happened. You know, I knew a little bit. Again, a lot of old people, they can see this movie and they say, oh yeah, this is exactly what happened. For us kind of millennials, like, we kind of know a little bit, but we just don't know all the details. And then if you're born in 2001, you just don't know anything. So I encourage you, young people, to see this so people can see what really happened before they were born. just my recommendation. It's a really good movie. They did a really, really good job for this movie. So I really do encourage you guys to go see this. Again, as advice, y'all, for the Lucas Review. Thank you for staying tuned for the Lucas Review. This has been Lucas Review, of course, with your host, KLP Kennedy Lucas. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel, of course. I'll link all the